Welcome to the Rustic Garden. Today I'm going to show you how to prepare Coco Coir bricks to use for your seed starting material. I've used this before in the past, but mostly I've used peat moss, vermiculite, perlite, and I've made a combination of materials. I've used starting mixes, and I decided this year to go with the Coco Coir because the price has really come down. It's a sterile starting medium, which is definitely what you want for germinating seeds, and it really has great water retention, and it's 100% renewable. It comes from the coconut husks. I purchased it in bags of 10. These are 250 gram bricks, about 9 ounces, and I bought 2 bags with 10 bricks in each of them. It cost me maybe $42-$43 shipped. So each brick costs about $2.20. That's a pretty good price. It's going to fill up at least one starting tray worth of seed cells like this. Let me show you how you set it up. You want to add water. You can use cold water, but it's going to go a little bit more slowly. I like to put in boiling water for the sake that the boiling water will be an extra precaution against making sure that this is sterile medium. This is probably kiln dried, pressed and kiln dried, so anything in here has been killed off with heat, but why not add boiling water, kill it off even more. Before I get to that, I want to show you what came with the package. And the main features of Coco Coir, which I agree with, high water holding capacity, which is definitely something you want when you are starting seeds. Retains and releases nutrients, naturally weed-free, disease-resistant, spongy texture, excellent for air and space drainage, develops elaborate root systems, neutral, slightly acidic pH, which is a little bit better, they say, than peat moss, but I've never had issue with that. And you could use it for soil amendments in a garden, but I'm not going to use it for that. But the sake that it really holds water is outstanding. There are no weeds. It is resistant to disease. I had better success with that, not getting molds, than some of my other starting mixes. Does have a spongy texture, which gives great airspace for the root systems to develop in your germinating seeds and your transplants. Now, there's no nutrients in here whatsoever, so there's two ways that you can do this. I'm going to do both ways. The first way is 1 teaspoon of a liquid fertilizer. Just put it on there. What this will do is it will give your plants some nutrients. When they get past their first initial 2 leaves, they're going to be looking for nutrients, and it will be in there. When a seed germinates, it actually uses the seed coat for nutrients, and it's not until they get their first set of true leaves that they're really looking for nutrients. But just put in hot water right onto the brick, and you'll see how quickly it expands. And it doesn't take long. I mean, it's holding all the water, and it really does hold 7 times its weight in water. So the liquid, it is liquid fertilizer, but the dry crystals will mix with the hot water, and your liquid fertilizer will get spread throughout all of this. That should work. It is a little bit hot. It'll cool off very quickly as you break it up. You can see the steam coming off, but this is just a good way to set this up. And make sure that it's sterile. Now, we put in the liquid or the crystals for the liquid fertilizer so that it mixed with the hot water and it got mixed throughout the whole block of Coco Coir. You could also just sprinkle in a fertilizer of choice. This is a fertilizer I made in other videos. This is really a mix of so many things, I'm not even going to go into it. But this is all organic, and there's a lot of green sand in here, so this is not all fertilizer. There's different things in there. And you would just mix that in too. Don't overdo it. I know that I used less with the blue crystals, and I used less with the tablespoons of the dry stuff. You just need a little bit in here, so you don't need to overdo it. So this is all mixed and ready to go. And it's really light, it's really fluffy, and it's really hot. It'll cool down in a second. But you can see how nice it is. This is a great starting mix. And I used it last year, but it was kind of expensive. All you do is fill up your tray. Always press it down, thumb pack it a little bit. And then you have 6 cells ready for your seeds. And you're going to be able to do, I know from experience, you're going to be able to fill at least one tray worth of cells in here from one 250-gram brick. So that's only about $2.20 to set up this whole tray. If you don't have these trays or you can't get them, sometimes you can find these cells and you can just use these tins, roasters, pans from the grocery store and just drop them in there. But Coco Coir, I think, makes a great alternative for starting seeds because, one, it's 100% renewable. It does hold a lot of water, which is really nice. It's germ-free, weed-free, mold-free, to start at least. And, I mean, it's just really, really light. You're going to have a nice starting mix to help your germinating seeds get off to a great start. Hope you enjoyed the video and consider using Coco Coir. Again, these are 250-gram bricks. They're only about $2.20. You can get them off of eBay. I would suggest you go on there and look for the bulk deals of buying 20 to 40 at a time, and you'll save money. But this is really, really a great way to get starting mix delivered to your house in a nice compact brick. It will expand 7 times its size, and it will take care of at least one tray worth of seed starting cells. Please check out my blog at www.therestofgarden.blogspot.com and also check out my YouTube videos. Thanks.